So for the performance of any equipment, we mean in the form of either momentum transfer, heat transfer or mass transfer or combination thereof, and we supply energy for enhancing the rates. And if it is supplied in the form of pressure energy, then all those equipment fall in the category of one. Now the static mixer and the static mixing element, you might have seen our laboratory. Have you seen the static mixer? All right. And various designs of static mixer. The whenever any fluid flows inside, like a spoon, there is flow past immersed body. And whatever comes in the way, the eddies are generated, the laminar flow is converted into turbulent, the turbulent flow is converted into intense turbulent, and we supply the energy for enhancing the rates of heat mass and momentum transfer, right? And then these equipment are used for either enhancing the rate of mixing or rate of heat transfer near the wall, or it may be the dispersion of gas into liquid. So extra energy which is dissipated inside is used for breaking the bubbles into smaller bubbles or breaking bigger drops into smaller drops in order to get better liquid-liquid dispersion or better gas-liquid dispersion. The point is, we are discussing pressure energy, and static mixers is one of them. So bubble columns, packed bubble columns, sectionalized bubble columns, external loop airlift reactors, internal loop airlift reactors, six equipment. Exactly the same can be used for liquid-liquid. For solid liquid, we also saw a fixed bed, a fluidized bed. And in all these cases, homogeneous and heterogeneous regimes are possible. So we saw fluidized bed. We also saw external loop, both for gas solid system and liquid solid system. For gas liquid solid, I explained to you the meaning of slurry reactor and the meaning of three-phase fluidized bed. So maybe 18-20 we have already covered. Now let us come to the kinetic energy. See, in principle, if you see, take a typical pressure energy equipment, right? We said that the pressure associated with the gas has to be higher than the static pressure existing at the bottom. That has to be there. And therefore, this equipment becomes pressure energy equipment. In a classical pack column, we need to pump the liquid at the top of the column. Now liquid is available at a height, right? In the form of potential energy, therefore that is potential energy equipment, right? But in principle, if you see, when gas is compressed, the energy is given to the gas for pressurization is done by rotary compressor, right? When this liquid is pumped at the top, that is also pumped and impeller rotates. When there is a stirred contactor, the category 2, we supply the energy in the form of kinetic energy. There is also kinetic energy we use. There also there is some rotation. The classification is entirely based on how the equipment receives the energy, right? At the bottom of the column, the gas has to be compressed to certain pressure, therefore that is pressure. How that is pressurized, that we don't consider while classification. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Right. So stirred tanks are the kinetic energy equipment. And household mixer is known to you. Typically the sizes are half a liter, 1 liter. Is 2 liter mixer possible in the household? How many? All of you must have seen, no? Right. And then there are 2-3 types of impellers which are provided. you should think really, is that the good design? After I teach you the strut tanks. So, I told you the classification is entirely based on the form of energy as received by the equipment. All right. So, when impeller rotates, it generates flow and flow is turbulent. So, the fluid in the equipment receives the energy in the form of mean kinetic energy as well as turbulent kinetic energy. Now, let me take any one impeller. So, this is an impeller, right? And this impeller creates turbulence as well as creates mean flow, right? The mean flow u square upon 2 is the mean kinetic energy per unit mass. And if there is a fluctuating velocity in addition to mean velocity, which is a representative of turbulence, then that fluctuation u prime square upon 2 is turbulent kinetic energy per unit mass. So, whenever impeller rotates, in majority of cases, the flow is turbulent and energy is received by the contents of the strut tank in the form of mean kinetic energy and turbulent kinetic energy. And therefore, these equipment are categorized under kinetic energy category, right? Now, there are large number of designs. Just now I mentioned there are a couple of designs in the household mixer, but there are plenty designs, and all these impeller designs are classified further. And there are various ways in which we classify the impellers, right? The first method is the direction in which the flow is generated by the impeller. That is the first way of classification. Whether it generates axial flow, and axis means the shaft, whether it generates the axial flow parallel to the shaft, the radial flow, the perpendicular to the shaft, and tangential flow. So, this is the first category, right? I am going to show you large number of designs under each category. The second classification is called closed clearance impellers versus open impellers. In closed clearance impeller, as the name suggests, the impeller size is practically equal to the tank size, and the clearance between the impeller and the vessel is very small. So, that is the second category. The third category is third way of classification. Though I am telling you very fast, I am going to give you sufficient time for assimilation as well as for writing all these classifications. The third classification is, I have already told you that the flow generated by the impeller is both mean kinetic energy and turbulent kinetic energy. If the mean kinetic energy is the major form of energy, then these are called flow impellers. If more than 90% is mean kinetic energy, if more than 90% is turbulent kinetic energy, then these are called turbulence creating impellers, head creating impellers, right? So, these are the three classifications, and there is one more classification I will tell you little later. So, what I am going to do now, under each category I am going to show you impellers. First of all, I will show you what is the meaning of radial flow, axial flow and tangential flow. So the flow leaving the impeller blade is radial here. The flow leaving the blade is actually upwards. And if we rotate the impeller, suppose this is clockwise and it is a flow impeller, if you rotate counterclockwise, the same impeller will become downflow impeller. And this tangential impeller, typically I have shown it by anchor, and when anchor rotates, the entire flow is the tangential. So if you see in plan view, in this case, there is a circulatory motion which is generated by the tangential flow impeller. So this is classification number one, right? The direction in which the flow released from the impeller looks like. Now let me show you good number of impellers. Most probably I'm going to show you radial impellers first. So these are typically the components of strut tank. There is a motor. There is a gearbox. Typically motor is 1440 RPM or 2880 RPM, and the impellers in the tank, they don't rotate at 1440 or 2880. It is in the range of 20 to say maximum 300. 90-95% of the impeller must be rotating in the range of 20 to 300 or say maximum 400. So therefore we need a gearbox to reduce the speed. Then here, that do you have engineering drawing as a subject? Yes. Have you drawn gland and stuffing box any time?
Yes, sir.
Right? And mechanical seal? Right. So my suggestion to you is you download or observe on internet the design of mechanical seal. The gland and stuffing box and mechanical seal, the jobs are the same, whereas the frictional energy loss in gland and stuffing box is much higher than in mechanical seal. In gland and stuffing box, about 30% of the energy supplied by the motor converts into heat at the gland and stuffing box itself, whereas in mechanical seal it is less than 10%. So since you have drawn gland and stuffing box, it is very easy for you to understand mechanical seal. So wherever the impeller enters the vessel, there is either gland and stuffing box or mechanical seal. Then there is a shaft and impeller and vessel. Vessel has a cylindrical portion and the ends are either elliptical, torospherical or hemispherical. And then there are baffles, and as a other internal there can be coils. So I think one is cylindrical vessel, two is, these are dish bottoms, three is impeller, fourth is a shaft, five is a seal, either gland and stuffing box or mechanical seal. Six are baffles, which can be two or three or four or six or eight, that I'll explain you. Then seven is a gearbox. Eight is a motor. Seven, this is gearbox and this is motor and this is the liquid level. So generally this is the arrangement, right? And this is the impeller. One statement I'm going to make just now, pack columns, have you studied in the class for absorption, for distillation?
Yes.
With different types of packings, including structured packings, etc.
Yes.
All right. Have you studied liquid distributor at the top? Some designs?
Not,
no? Not designed, but have you seen the picture? Picture you have seen, right? Impellers, some pictures you have seen?
Yes.
Right. in practically all the cases, here if you take total stirred vessel and say capacity is 5 tons, the total weight of the stirred tank is likely to be about 10 tons. Whereas, the weight of the impeller is of the order of 50 kilograms. So, 50 kilograms is negligible as compared to 10 tons. Right? The distributor, for example, and this also costs, though it weighs less than 1%, impeller may cost 5% of the total. Similarly, liquid distributor in pack column may also cost less than 5%. Similarly, all pressure equipment, the spargers which I showed you schematically, the spider sparger and the ring sparger and the wheel sparger and the radial sparger for gas. Similarly, there are different distributor designs for liquid in liquid and for gas solid fluidization. So, these spargers, they also cost less than 5%. So, impellers in kinetic energy equipment, they control the performance of the equipment, which is more than 90%, though they cost 5%. The distributors in potential energy type of equipment, they also control 90% of the performance. And distributors in pressure type of equipment, so these components in the equipment are very critical. I think we should attend to that. Whenever either we are designing or we are analyzing the problems associated with existing equipment, quickly we should go to these equipment, these components of the equipment. What is the sparger design, what was originally provided, what is the current status, or what was the impeller as selected, what is the current impeller, what is the optimum impeller required for the current purpose, and whether we can improve the performance. So, these are the typical components. We have already classified the impellers, and let us see the different impellers. So, again a stirred tank is shown. So, baffles are there, all those 7-8 components are there. So, in this case there is one impeller, and in another case there are 3 impellers. I described to you, we can put in different amounts of energy to the equipment, right? And then accordingly there is a performance. At the end we compare that we have supplied this much energy, this much performance is there, and at the end we make a selection that I am going to supply this much energy and design the equipment. Having decided, it is likely that after rotating one impeller, that much desired quantity we cannot supply to the liquid. Therefore, we take multiple impellers, either 2 or 3, so that we can add the design. We can provide 4 impellers, 5 impellers, right? So, accordingly, suppose it is up to 1 kilowatt per ton, single impeller is a good idea. More than 2.5, then 2 impellers are required. If you want 10, then 3 impellers are required, right? So, therefore, multiple impeller system or single impeller. But how much energy to be supplied to the equipment is our job, and how to do that I'm definitely going to teach. Now, my one request to you is, I make promises like this. All of you, you write on the last page, are you bringing the same notebook every time? So, on the last page, you write all my promises. and I will not leave this class till all the promises are satisfied. The first one I told you that I am going to teach you the design of equipment which is most complex in the world. Write that. What is the promise I made just now? I forgot, therefore I am telling you. I did not make any promise just now. Our promise itself is not understood. What did I say? That is one. That anyway I will teach. But the second one, and I must have made promises in the last 3-4 classes. So all are forgotten now. But at least today's promise, you right? What did I say? How to select a particular level of energy, whether we need to perform experiments in the laboratory in order to optimize the energy to be supplied for the equipment, that's what I said. So selection of the level of energy to be supplied to the equipment, the methodology for that, that I promised. Okay. Are you able to see? There is a central disk, and here you can see there are 4 blades. The 4 blades are attached, something like what I have drawn here. There is a disk and then the blades are attached. So there can be 4 blades or 6 blades, and this is radial flow impeller, the first radial flow impeller. This is called, the first one is called disk turbine, this is called curved blade turbine. But is again radial flow impeller. Do you want all these slides with you? Yes. Should I distribute to you? This is another radial flow. This is radial flow impeller. There are rods. These are 6 rods. And at the end, there is a square blade. Aray, next time we should bring these impellers physically. Physically, so that will be more appropriate. Are you able to guess what is this shape? Rods you can see, that much is clear. Correct, no? Right. And at the end, there is a square blade attached to the to the rod. And this is radial flow. In axial flow impellers, I'll say that little later. So this is called radial flow propeller. Why it is called, I'll explain little later. But how many radial flow impellers we saw? 5, the disk turbine, the curved blade turbine, then flat blade turbine. And this is the radial propeller. This is the radial propeller, curved blade turbine, straight blade turbine, right. So this is a blade which is in the form of half circle, which is also radial impeller, and there is one more radial impeller where instead of half circle, it is a parabola. All these are radial flow impellers. So disk turbine, straight blade turbine, curved blade turbine, then the half circle, it is suggested by one company and they have named it as CD6. That is the name. But how it looks like is a half circle. Parabola, the name given by the company, the manufacturer is gas foil. Right, Why do we give any name?
Order.
Yeah, that is there. You have name, I have name, correct, no? We have name. And we know the meaning also, these names. Similarly, these names are given. This straight blade turbine, curved blade turbine, the propeller. So I showed you 6 or 7 radial. Then this is axial flow turbine, the axial flow turbine, where the blades are attached to the hub at an angle. You imagine a hub. This is a good blade. Imagine wherever I am holding is welded to the shaft, connected to the shaft. And now I rotate, it is inclined. And top edge, while rotating like this, is leading, whereas bottom edge is lagging while rotating. So if top edge is leading, whether it will create downflow or upflow? Very good, very good. And if it rotates like this, the upflow. So the same impeller, either by design you can attach the blade in such a way that we rotate all the time clockwise. So we design either upflow or downflow. So how many parameters are there? There are number of blades. There is a blade width. There is angle at which it is connected to the hub, and if the blade is twisted, then angle at the tip. So all axial flow impellers is a combination of the number of blades, the width of the blade, width and angle near the hub, width and angle near the tip. And if you see all axial flow impellers, they will fall under this description, and I am going to show you some of them. Here are 6 blades, width is 30% of the diameter and attached at 45 degrees. Right? Another one. This is also 30%, but as you can see, the blade is twisted. Every blade is twisted. So at the tip is the angle less than the angle at the hub, or it is more than. Let us measure angle with respect to horizontal. Is it twisted? In what manner? Angle is less or more? Yeah, correct. Very good. Now here, the angle is same, but width is increasing. I am making one more statement, and you remember throughout your life. Say 50 years you remember, not longer than that, okay? Are you attentive?
Yes.
Yeah. I showed you up till now 7, 8, 9 impellers. And there are equipment manufacturers, impeller manufacturers, and they make very attractive brochures, and they come to you and say that my product is so good, you will get with very little energy, you will get very good performance, right? And then they print the brochures in very attractive manner. The statement I am making is, don't get carried away by the appearance of the salesperson and the quality of brochure. If the quality is very good of the brochure, and person is very smart with tie and coat, you don't believe him. How many years you will remember? 50 years. We should analyze the performance ourselves, right? If the performance is really good as promised, we really compliment that person, really very good. You have done a good job. If the person says which is not really correct, then give a big smile. You'll remember this?
Yes,
right. giving a big smile is a very good idea in life. Don't complain, don't quarrel, give a big smile. You will be successful. I'm telling you, all of you, how to get Padma Bhushan. If you complain, you are wasting your energy. And energy is useful for the equipment as well as for us. We must conserve our energy. Remember, for 60 years. So all these shapes are there, and see so many. How many changes are there? Width is changing, angle is changing, number of blades are 4. Here number of blades are 3, and this is a very popular impeller. What is this called? Yeah, somebody said very correct. This is called propeller. This is another 3-bladed, only the width is changing. Here width and angle is changing. By the way, it looks very simple, called HE3 by the manufacturer, but very popular. This is A310. There are three companies in the world who supply in a big way. So this is mixing equipment company, and they have named it as A310. And this is the name of the company is written here, Ikato. Ikato is a Japanese company. The Robin is a German company. Mixing equipment company is a US company. And there is one more company. This is also by mixing equipment company. But there are two. The radial propeller, which I showed you some diagram, now it is clearer how that blade is connected at the end. Is that right? Right. Okay. So all these, but this is radial flow impeller. I was showing all up till now axial flow impellers. Now this is tangential flow. This one is tangential flow, but close clearance. The clearance between impeller tip and the vessel wall is very small. Whereas this is also close clearance impeller. So another category, close clearance impellers versus the open impellers. The diameter of open impellers and all the impellers which I showed, right from disc turbine, straight blade turbine and curved blade turbine, and the propeller, the axial propeller and radial propeller, and pitch blade turbines, different widths and angles, etc., all were open impellers, where impeller diameter, in majority of cases, it is less than 50% of the vessel diameter. And in close clearance impellers, it is close, it is really close. In some of the helical ribbon, there is no clearance. The impeller is, you will surprise then how the impeller rotates, if it is tightly fitting inside, all right? So what is done is, some gap is kept, but that gap is filled with a flexible strip. A flexible strip is connected at the end so that the flexibility of that particular strip, either Teflon or flexible metal, that takes the shape of the wall, and then there is no clearance. So these are the two, the helical ribbon perhaps you have not understood. I don't expect also. But have you seen a staircase like this, the helically coming down? Have you seen your own hostel? Hostel number one? Is there any staircase like this? Is it there at that time? It was there in 1969. Is it there? You go near the faculty house, and from there you look at the hostel number one and see whether it is there. Anyway, what is done is there is a strip which is taken helically downwards, and if I want to draw, I'm going to spend time on this impeller mainly because personally I have been using this type of impeller in many cases. Are you getting me? It's difficult. Yeah, it's difficult. If you would have understood, then I would have surprised really. What is that I can do? Give me some idea. Helix, you understand?
Yes, sir.
What is the closest example?
DNA,
yeah, DNA. Have you seen any children park? You must have gone to the park when you yourself right? So there is an incline which is straight incline, right? On which you can slide. Right? But there is one where there is a central shaft, and then you start sliding at the top and helically you come down. Have you seen that?
Yes.
Yeah. So that is helical impeller. There are some versions like this helix. This is called single helix impeller. And if there is one more helix, this is called double helix impeller. Right? And these are always axial flow impellers. These are axial flow impellers. So either this is actually upwards or actually downwards. If there are actually downwards, then there is one more modification made. At the center, this is a shaft. At the center, a screw is connected, which is upward. So the helix near the wall, it gives downward flow, and it can be reverse also. The helix can give upward flow, whereas the screw. So it is single helical ribbon or double helical ribbon or double helical screw ribbon or single helical screw ribbon, that is also possible, right? So all these are close clearance impellers. Let me see whether I have, all right. Now this I am going to teach little later. This I will teach little later. So I have shown you enough number of close clearance impellers, at least four. That is, there is one more close clearance impeller, which is called a paddle or a gate. If you have not understood the helical ribbon, definitely go to children park. And slide yourself and report to me. There are enough parks, in every park it is there. In the gate is of course very simple, gate is a gate. As if it is a gate for bungalow. So this is also close clearance impeller. Among close clearance impellers, now gates, anchors and paddles are no more popular. So you can take this as a final decision, that is close clearance impeller, whenever we wish to design, it will be either single helix, double helix or together with screw. I am going to teach you one more classification, that is the flow generating impeller versus turbulence generating impeller. Are you tired? Okay, I will teach you next time.